I'm now the fourth United States president to preside over American troop presence in Afghanistan. I will not pass this responsibility onto a fifth. It's time to end America's longest war. It's time for American troops to come home.
On an anniversary that marks one of the darkest days in American history, 2,500 U.S. forces will withdraw from Afghanistan.
We went to Afghanistan because of a horrific attack that happened 20 years ago. That cannot explain why we should remain there in 2021.
And NATO allies are in lockstep, with Britain announcing its 750 troops will be out by September. Australia following suit today, confirming the removal of our final 80 personnel.
Since 2001, 41 Australian personnel have lost their lives while serving in Afghanistan. Today, the government is announcing that Australia will conclude the drawdown of our contribution to the NATO-led Resolute Support mission in Afghanistan.
But the decision has left people wondering if that mission has been accomplished.
No, we're not talking about mission accomplished in Afghanistan. Potentially after 20 years, we'll see the Taliban come back to power in close alliance with Al-Qaeda. So that's exactly what we don't want. This could be the worst decision of the Biden presidency.
And the Taliban should know that if they attack us as we draw down, we'll defend ourselves and our partners with all the tools at our disposal.
Despite Biden's warning, there are serious concerns the withdrawal will see the Taliban return to power in the region. In fact, it's already spinning this as a victory.
We would like to imagine that's not going to happen because we've spent 20 years trying to stop it happening. But if we just turn away now because we're tired, then the terrorists win. They were trying to wear us out to fatigue us, knowing that eventually we'd go home. We need to be smarter than that.
Nearly 20 years since the war began, an all-too-familiar fear is creeping back.
We're likely to see in the next 12 months the Taliban completely come back to power, including in Kabul. We're likely to see women forced out of the workplace, out of schools. We're likely to see a return to the days of darkness we knew 20 years ago with the Taliban. It doesn't have to be that way, but if we say we're not going to do anything more, then we've got a major moral failure and a major humanitarian disaster looming within the next 12 months.
Is it worth it going to Afghanistan?
Freedom's always worth it.
Yeah, and I think by some projections, the war in Afghanistan cost $1.3 trillion. I think depending on the numbers that you read, up to 40,000 Afghanis have lost their lives. So I think it's such a tricky question. I know we heard Greg in that piece say that now's not the time to leave, it's the worst decision of the Biden presidency. I guess it's more a question of if we don't leave now, where we've been for 20 years, when do we leave? When is the right time to leave? When will the mission be accomplished? What will it take?
Yes, it's like some people regard the war as like it's become a permanent fixture. Mm. Now the shock that you're ending this permanent fixture is resonating, but what's the alternative?
Because the concern is, you know, the Taliban is just waiting to get back in there. And there has been a lot of good work that's been done. I mean, girls are in school, women are in mm-hmm. jobs, and, you know, the human rights issues that could become a real issue again is the concern. But I suppose 20 years is kind of a neat anniversary for September 11 in the US.
Well,
maybe
it's
about the politics.
But do wars just correspond with, like, neat anniversaries? It's strange,
yeah.
isn't it, to think like that? I understand it's a significant date for America.
Yeah.
But it's like not wrapping a parcel and putting a neat bow on it.
Mm. Yeah, that's true.
We will find out.
We
that's
will.
For sure.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.